Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Aditya 11TTT. Today we have a case of NM-A361 motherboard. This is a Lenovo motherboard. The problem of this motherboard, when we connect the power adapter and try to switch on, the board is not getting on. Okay, this is the problem of the motherboard. Now we are going to check step by step to find out the fault of this motherboard. Now what we are going to do is we are going to check the impedance of the input side and the output MOSFET. So this is the first MOSFET, this is the second MOSFET. So let me check it to the impedance mode. First I am going to check the impedance of this first MOSFET. This is the output side. You can see it is 542.542. Now I am going to check on the output side of this second MOSFET over here. You can see it is showing short. So in this situation, it indicates me that my after second MOSFET, there is a some shorting. So what I am going to do is I am going to connect the DC power supply. Now what I've done is I have just connected a wire that is directly from my DC power supply in order to find the shorting, where is the shorting on my board. This is a 19 volt line which is short, so I'm going to connect the negative terminal on this jack and try to find out if any of my component is heating. This is the best use of DC power supply, from which we can find the shorting very easily. So let me check if I am able to find it or not. So let me connect the wire first. I have connected the wire. Now I'll increase the voltage slowly. Don't increase this together, otherwise your board will short. So you can see as soon as I am increasing the voltage, my ampere is also increasing. This clearly indicates that there is some shorting on the board. So let's see whether I am able to find the short or not. I am going to increase the voltage to around 1.5 voltage. You can see the ampere is also increasing and it has increased to 0.8 ampere. So let me try to find out if I am able to find the short somewhere. You can also use different methods to find the short, but this is the easiest method which I use for finding the short. You can also use the IR camera if you have to find the short, that will be more easy, but it is a costly affair. So this side I am not able to see or find any kind of shortage, so I am going to tilt the board. First let me disconnect, let me make it zero again and then connect it again. You should be very careful when you are using this trick, because you need to be professional for this. If you use it without knowing or make any mistake, your motherboard will die, as this is the onboard CPU motherboard. So again I'll increasing to 1.5. you can see it is taking ampere again, and let me try to find if I am able to find any shorting or not. I am able to feel the heat on this capacitor. This capacitor is getting hot. There are two capacitors, out of which one seems to be faulty. So what I am going to do is I am going to remove this capacitor. Let me try to show you. If let me also try to pour some IP. Let's see, the IP is getting evaporated. If yes, then I think so, we have found our shorting. You can see the IP is getting evaporated from this area. That means out of these two capacitors, one is short. So what we are going to do is we are going to remove the capacitor and see whether it is short or not. So let me remove it. So I have removed one capacitor from here, this area, and after removing this capacitor, this is the capacitor. After removing this, the shorting has gone. I'll show you on the multimeter also. You can see the impedance has increased to around 400. 470 around. It has increased over here, which we are checking. So this is how we found that the capacitor is short using DC power supply. Now what I'm going to do is I am going to connect a new capacitor over here from another board. I am going to take and put it back, a new capacitor for safety protection purpose. So let me put this capacitor and come back to you. So we have replaced successfully the capacitor over here. Now we are going to check the impedance again. Let's check on the, you can see this is the ground part which is already short, and other side we check, you can see it is a good impedance now, 4.485. okay, so let's see whether the input side that we have soldered the wire previously, is the shorting gone from there or not. So let's check it over there. So here we have soldered the wire. You can see the impedance is good now. It is a good impedance. Now the shorting is gone. Let's remove and check whether the board is powering on or not, because previously it was not getting on. Now let's move ahead. Let's remove this wire first. So we have connected the board with the DC power supply after changing the capacitor which was short. And we are going to check it on the multimeter as well as on the ampere, that is DC power supply, whether it is ticking or not. Right now I have set to 16 volt. You can see it is 16 volt. And this is the first resistance, which is right now, because the voltage is low, 16.8. That's why it is showing 0.869. Now let's increase it to 19 volt. You can see as we have increased to 19 volt, it is powering on and taking 0.3 ampere, and you can also see the voltage over here is now 18.56 voltage. Okay, so going to put it back into the laptop bezel and going to check the display, whether it is the display is coming or not. Let's connect the display screen and check first, then we'll go into assemble it. So let me take the board to the screen part and let's connect it. Okay. So we have connected the board to the screen over here, and we are going to plug the supply to it. You can see the light is glowing, and let's see whether the display is coming or not. You can see over here the display is out. The board is working now. The display is coming. The board is getting automatic on because CMOS battery is not installed right now. So basically it is on now. The board is on now. I have switched it off with the help of power button, and I am going to switch it on. You can see the display is coming. The board is working perfectly fine. So problem was in the capacitor that was short. We have removed the capacitor and the problem is being solved. So we have assembled the laptop now, and I am going to switch it on. So you can see the laptop is booting now, and Windows is also loading properly. So you can see it has booted. So our problem of shorting has been resolved.
So thanks for watching Aditya 11 Triple T. Hope you like this channel. Do hit the subscribe button, like, share and comment. Thanks a lot.